build track record, because customer relations are going to be quite important. People are going to have that hysteresis curve, I don't know if you know the term. But basically, I may not trust somebody and I may not start working with him or her. But having worked with them for 3 to 5 years, it would take a lot more effort for somebody to dislodge anyone from buying from customer to customer. So track record and building of relationships is the value and gives you the value. You have to be efficient, you have to be competent. You cannot really say, just chalta hai, dependability is an important issue in terms of the mind of the customer. Agar kisi customer ko kehte ho ye ho gaya, 10 log nahi aaye aaj, to aaj mera shipment 2 weeks late ho gaya, 1 week late ho gaya. Customer doesn't care. He may understand, he may empathize, but he does not have the ability to really tolerate that problem, at least if it is frequent. Because what is going to happen is that he says, no, yaar abhi ye banda acha hai, I like him, but kya nahi hai, uska delivery time is never reliable. So you have to be dependable, you have to have competent people, and you have to have competence in terms of everything, and response times are important. So let me just put everything together quickly. Basically, you have to think, so you have to imagine the future, and you have to say, this is the future I want to have. And I have to hold the future that would imply changes. So you have to prepare yourself and others for the change that you entail in terms of going from here to there. Efficiency in all operations, quest to do proactively and better than others is something that has to become a culture of your organization. Keep eyes on leveraging innovation, technology, and globalization, which will give you an edge. And discover how to use organizations like SEED or mentors, experts, etc., to be able to leverage. The important thing as far as the last bullet is concerned is that a lot of work has to be done by us. Sometimes we get people in IT and say, I want to scale up the world as if global or media. The work has to be done. The word that I use inside I create is the onus. The onus of success is on you. Nobody else can take that onus. Other people can help, but being able to get other people to help you is an art. So you have to know exactly what other people can do, what is it that you need, what are the missing elements, how you can bring all the missing elements together, and then ask for help. If you only can put me in touch with this fellow, right? That is the help of networking. Okay, you want to get in touch with that fellow? I will give him a call. I will say, ye banda hai, tu milna chahta hai, agar aapke paas 10 minute hai, to tujhe 10 minute dena. That's it. Right? Abhi aap unko boliye, naya bahut problem acha hai, main pump acha banata hu, ye karta hu. You know, that is where it gets into more and more complicated. You have to define exactly what help you absolutely need. Prepare all the other brands, seeking help, effectively seeking help is an art, and that art can be also understood. So I thought some few words put together to be able to evoke some thoughts, possibly nudge you to think differently. Anyway, Parul and our friends are going to be with you for a large number of assignments Saturday, so anyway.
There should be a lot of questions. I have quite a few, but I will reserve until you know and give opportunity to all of you to ask questions. And I am sure my questions will be answered. So please raise your questions.
Of course, sir, change is difficult to digest everybody.
Yes.
But we have to accept that challenge. Now, can you focus on change little bit? Those who are older employees, of course, for you there is no problem.
Yes.
But who are those who are 10 years, 15 years old people?
Yes.
They doesn't allow change, and sometimes the old issue also.
Oh, but that is the reason why I have brought that Kari video clip. Status quo.
That lady.
power play, it's something that is going to be always there in every organization. Age makes it more difficult to change, which is also true. But if you work, so there is more effort required in convincing them. There is another major issue, sincerity versus competence.
Sincerity versus competence.
Especially for small companies. You bring people who are competent from outside, and there are sincere people inside who have been with you for 10 years, 15 years. They are doing whatever they are doing well. These competent people bring some competence, but their price is high, and their stability is uncertain. Right. So that is, but बहुत आसान ही मेरे लिए बोलना है कि ये अगर हम ये करने को तैयार नहीं है तो हम वहाँ है. You have to distinguish yourself from the organization that you lead. And you have to say, if I want to lead the organization, I have to be able to do this. अगर हम अपने आप को organization से अलग रखते हैं, बोलेंगे हम इसको leader, हम इसका लीडर बनना चाहते हैं. अगर हम इसका लीडर बनना चाहते तो हमारे में कुछ होना चाहिए. नहीं कि मेरे पिताजी ने बनाया था इसलिए मैं इसका ऑटोमेटिकली लीडर हूँ. तो हमारे में कुछ होना चाहिए कि जिससे हम ये कहते हैं कि हम इसका लीडर होने के लिए कॉन्फिडेंस रखते हैं. अगर ये हम एक बार एक्सेप्ट कर लेते हैं कि अगर ये तो ये प्रॉब्लम डिफिकल्ट है तो क्या होगा, हमें इसको सॉल्व करना है, किस तरह से करना है, वो काफ़ी उसके बहुत लोगों ने किया है. Other people have done some of these things. The problems are same. Some people have solved them and some people talk about them. So, man talk about it. So, question is...
Is it talk about it? What are they?
Some people who have solved it, we bring them as case studies next time. Talk. Does that answer your question? Yes. Difficult, fear, vested interest, status quo is something that has to be dealt with. But it is our job. First, we have to make a resolve.
How to resolve that resolve?
That's why change yourself first, decide what is required to be done, then get prepared for the journey, and then make everybody come along with you. A short example. For better probably understanding. जो old people हो उनसे आप जो करना काम करवाना चाहते हैं वो खुद करना start कर दीजिए.
वो खुद करना चाहते
हैं start कर दीजिए. उनको demo दिखाइए कि मेरे जैसा old भी ये कर सकता है.
कर सकता है.
ठीक है. फिर वो भी करेंगे. फिर young भी करेंगे, old भी करेंगे. यंग तो काम करेंगे अगर मोटिवेटेड है.
यंग में प्रॉब्लम नहीं है.
ठीक है. ओल्ड में जो रेजिस्टेंस का प्रॉब्लम है उसका रीजन आप या आपका ऑर्गेनाइजेशन नॉट नेसेसरीली हो सकता है. मतलब उनके और भी प्रॉब्लम है. उनके हेल्थ प्रॉब्लम है, उनकी माइंड ऐसी कंडीशन हो गई, उनके घर के प्रॉब्लम है, उनके कई सारे प्रॉब्लम है सोसाइटी. वो समझ के जब आप स्टार्ट करेंगे कि आपके जैसे एज वाला अगर मैं जैसे मैं हो सकता हूँ आप जिनकी बात करते हैं उसके एज का आप शायद नहीं हो, लेकिन उस एज के लिए जो आप करवाना चाहते हैं तो खुद करेंगे किसी के भी तो वो स्टार्ट होगा. उसमें दिस इंस्टीट्यूट की सबसे पहली एडवेंचर जो एवरी ईयर ले जाते हैं डेलाउजी और वहाँ उनको सब एडवेंचर ट्रैकिंग, माउंटेन वॉकिंग, रिवर क्रॉसिंग, रेपलिंग. तो फर्स्ट टाइम मैं और मेरी वाइफ फर्स्ट बैच को लेके गए स्टूडेंट को अबाउट 40-45. वहाँ लास्ट में रेपलिंग लास्ट देते हैं. रेपलिंग यू नो कि वो बांध के आपको 90 डिग्री पे रॉक के ऊपर से पाँव अरे ये तो हाँ आपको पाँव से झटका लेके 90 डिग्री पे नीचे उतरना है रॉक से. दैट इज
रेपलिंग.
वो गर्ल्स वेर क्राइंग मोस्ट ऑफ देम के ये तो हम बॉयज वेर अफ्रेड तो वो भाग जाते हैं पीछे चले जाएंगे हमें नहीं करते. ठीक है. ऐसी हालत उसमें मैंने क्या सोचा कि अब क्या करें. यहाँ तो आ गए अब ये लोग नहीं करेंगे तो लाइफ टाइम का एक्सपीरियंस हम तो नहीं देंगे लेकिन इनको भी शायद नहीं मिलेगी. तो मैंने कहा वो इंस्ट्रक्टर को कि मुझे आप बता दो मुझे सिखा दो. सिखा दो मीन्स बता दो. वो बोले मैं सिखा नहीं सकता ना आपको है, मैं बता सकता. जैसे मधुबन में
बट यू हैव टू वो उन्होंने मुझे मैंने बोला मुझे पहले बात माय वाइफ वाज लुकिंग एट मी बिकॉज़ आई हैड अंडरगॉन अ ट्रिपल बाईपास सर्जरी ओनली 1 ईयर बिफोर
माय गॉड
ठीक है तो शी वाज लुकिंग एट मी एंड आई सेड इट इज ऑल राइट वन डे आई एम गोइंग टू डाई राइट व्हिच कुड नॉट बी टुडे इट इज स्टिल अ लॉन्ग टाइम बट इवन इफ इट इज टुडे व्हाट कैन आई डू ये मेरा डेस्टिनी होगा तो बोला नहीं कुछ आपको से बात करना है So she understood, she did not say it. And therefore, rattling मैंने किया. मैंने किया. First time in my life, मेरा कोई experience नहीं था. लेकिन मैंने सोचा, मैं अगर ये risk नहीं ले सकता हूँ as a director of the institute, मैं student को risk लेना क्या सिखाऊंगा? वही तो purpose है उनको ले जाने का. कि आप difficult condition पे डाल दो और फिर बोलो तुम manage करो. और तुम्हें कहीं problem है तो I am there. But I knew कि मेरा भी limitation है. मैं क्या कर सकता मैंने करने के बाद एक एक स्टूडेंट ने किया इंक्लूडिंग ऑल द गर्ल्स तो उसके बाद से ये एक रूल बन गया एवरी ईयर न्यू बैच आएगी सबसे पहले हम इनको डलहौजी में देंगे कोई ना कोई फैकल्टी जाए उसके बाद मैंने
ऐसा ही एक एग्जांपल है ये मैसणा में गया था मैं वाटर पार्क में वो बड़े से पाइप में से जाना होता है तो सब दूर भागते हैं तो मैंने क्या किया मेरी फैमिली में 10-12 आदमी थे सबसे आगे मैंने खुद को खड़ा किया फिर लगा कि कोई जवान भी है कोई दिलदार है मतलब ऐसे सब सेलेक्ट करके उनको लाइन से खड़ा कर दिया और सबसे जो ऐसा मानो सबसे डरपोक जो आदमी था उसको सबसे पीछे रखा तो 1, 2, 3, 4 वो लास्ट में तो वो भी बोलता नहीं तभी तो 11 चले गए तो मुझे भी जाना ही है ऐसा है
इसलिए अवेयरनेस जो है सेल्फ का
सक्सेस और
वो बहुत जरूरी है और वो एवरीडे आता है क्योंकि आज हम खुद को नहीं जानते हैं मैं बिल्कुल क्लियर और सिंपली बता रहा हूं आई स्टिल डोंट नो माय सेल्फ
टू नो द सेल्फ
बस तो
एनी अदर थॉट कमेंट्स क्वेश्चन
बढ़िया
बहुत अच्छा क्वेश्चन था और सभी को ये क्वेश्चन एप्लीकेबल होता है ऐसा क्वेश्चन पूरे ऑडियंस का क्वेश्चन आपने एक क्वेश्चन में सब
अरे साहब आ क्या पछु तुम्हें नवू लाया है शांति जीवा दो ना
करेक्ट दैट इज द रिएक्शन
तुमने सु सने बात पड़े क्या बता शांति रे जीवा जीवा दो ना सु ले जावन आई भी काम नहीं पर साहब ने बहुत सरस
कभी ऐसे लोगों को आप यहाँ इकट्ठा करो एंड आई विल एड्रेस देम
नहीं नहीं आपने तो
के ये तो एक छोटा एग्जांपल है बट आई विल एड्रेस देम ऑन के कैसे वो सब लोगों को मोटिवेट जैसे ओएनजीसी के जनरल मैनेजर के बाद बेसिन मैनेजर का एक ही पोजीशन है एक रीजन में वेस्टर्न रीजन में उसमें से एक जीएम बनेगा
बस ओनली वन
15-20-25 जीएम है यहाँ फिर इतने वहां मेहसाना में इतने गांधीनगर में उसमें से एक शायद बनेगा नहीं तो दिल्ली से तेरा कुछ आएगा मतलब कोई चांस नहीं है जिनको आगे प्रमोशन नहीं है उनको मोटिवेशन करने के लिए बुलाया था कि इनको मोटिवेट करो अपनी मोटिवेटर नहीं है क्योंकि इनको प्रमोशन के चांस नहीं है और पूरी सैलरी मिल रही है पूरे रिटायरमेंट बेनिफिट है इनको कोई तकलीफ नहीं है इसलिए मोटिवेटेड नहीं है
सही बात राइट राइट एग्जैक्टली राइट
तो उसके बाद बुला दे रहे हैं तो ये आप इकट्ठा करिए ऐसे लोगों को जितने एम्प्लॉइज आप सबके ऐसे हैं जो रेजिस्टेंस टू चेंज वाले हैं उनको एक छोटा सा प्रोग्राम देंगे
डेफिनेटली
ओवरकमिंग रेजिस्टेंस टू चेंज
ओवरकमिंग
रेजिस्टेंस टू चेंज
यस फॉर द
गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबॉडी
गुड मॉर्निंग
बिफोर आई स्टार्ट आई हैड टू वॉक ऑफ द डायस Because I am not in the league of Dr. Kajuria and Dr. Mehta. I've been an entrepreneur for the past 25 years, so I am one of you.
Right.
So I first, before beginning, I want to ask how many of you are entrepreneurs?
Simply all.
All of you are first generation entrepreneurs?
Yeah,
second. So if you are all first generation entrepreneurs, then you will absolutely relate with what I have to say because I've been one myself. When you start entrepreneurship or when you start your new company, you are full of enthusiasm. You are extremely excited about setting up a different world, of making your mark in the world. And that momentum and enthusiasm actually propels you forward. It's a lot of hard work for the first couple of years until you set your organization. When I started mine and I started the marketing to my customers, the first thing that my customer told me is, how long have you been operator? And I said, okay, I've been operator for 6 months. And he said, come back to me after 1,000 days. If you have survived for 1,000 days, then I will speak with you and I will buy your product. And I told him, if you don't buy my product and if everybody says the same thing, how will I survive for 1,000 days? So it's a cash delivery situation for every entrepreneur, whatever be your kind of business. You may be in service, you may be in manufacturing, you may be even a self-made individual who is doing some kind of independent activity on your own. But the struggle remains the same. And the drive also remains the same for almost everybody who has survived those 1,000 days. But what happens after? After those 1,000 days, what happens? You have set your organization, you have a lot of people working for you, and you feel in a position of power because you are settled. That is the most dangerous time of your enterprise.
Oh.
The minute you feel secure, the minute you feel I am there, your decline has begun. So, unfortunately, my slides and Madhubai's slides will be kind of
overlapping
each other because we both worked on our presentations independently and in fact only came in after a month. So please excuse that, but I'll give you a brief outline. I'm going to talk a little bit about iCreate so that you have a sense of what iCreate does. I'll give you a brief of what we did in program part one because we've already been through that. I can see some participants here too. Some testimonials and feedback to give you a sense of what they felt after they finished the program because that is of importance. What our SME EDB part two is all about, the course outline, and last is question answers. Hoping to see all of you here. So let me start with International Center for Entrepreneurship and Technology. We call it an inspiring ecosystem for next generation entrepreneurs. Now, next generation entrepreneurs gives you a kind of buzz in your head because you all believe that you are not next generation. You are already there, so how can you be next generation? But our definition of next generation is a little different. We want to say also, why it is the right career choice for a lot of capable people, because the scope of activities of iCreate is extremely wide. It not only talks about new entrepreneurship, it also talks about why people can make it into the rightful career for them, because that is a mindset that we need to create in India. And the third part of it is also about how we can help people grow. So what is different? There are all kinds of businesses. There are the general lifestyle businesses, what we call as, which means you can have a restaurant, or you can have, the old style, day-to-day retail shops, other things, mom and pop shops, all these are what we consider as lifestyle businesses. And then we call something as next generation entrepreneurship. Businesses with scale, leveraging knowledge, leveraging technology, leveraging innovations, and global markets. So all these four, this is what your businesses need to become. We have become very complacent in our old style working, and it is also very difficult to change because it involves, allocation of finance, allocation of resources, getting the right manpower, getting the right kind of technical help. So we need to ensure that we are able to leverage our business into a next generation entrepreneurship. we have to be able to move along with the times, because just like if you are into a product manufacturing, you will find that the old grinding tape recorder which used to be there has died. The old typewriter that was there has died.
Out of it.
Similarly, our businesses, our processes, our products could die. And how we can ensure that our products stay for a very, very long time is if we are able to leverage the latest knowledge, the latest technology, how to make full use of the global markets, and how to continuously innovate products as well as services. So what are the characteristics of what we call as next generation entrepreneurship? The essential thing is to make a difference. Make a product or a service such that it makes a difference in somebody's life. It's not just a me-too product, it's not just a product that you can buy off the shelf, but it is a product with a distinct difference. How can you fill a need? When you're looking at new generation products, you have to see where the problems are. How can your product be modified in a manner that actually fills a proper need for the customer? How can it create next generation employment? How can I ensure that I can include so many more people in my organization to make a global enterprise? How to innovate? How to have a global outlook? How to do teamwork? All these are key elements of making a next generation.
I just want to add a line.
Yes.
That if you can observe all the points mentioned here, the last one is teamwork, which is taught in management, right? In management discipline, this is taught, but none of the other things are taught. You get it? Therefore, entrepreneurship development is much more fundamental before even the management. Management is all about the systems of doing work in an organization and how do you manage people and resources and markets. But entrepreneurship is all about developing self to be able to manage well. Now, these two are considered to be synonyms by many. That if I am an MBA, for example, I don't need to learn entrepreneurship, right? Because I don't want to work as an entrepreneur and I want to do a job. But what about being an intrapreneur or working as an entrepreneur within the organization? How CM, who is sitting here, and CM is a financial manager of
Well
Scientific, right? He works for some organization, but he has been a part of the organization for 25 years, I know him. And he works like an entrepreneur, intrapreneur, takes decisions. Now all that is taught in the entrepreneurship program. And this will appreciate the difference between the two.
The last word is pay forward. Does anybody understand the word pay forward?
आगे आने के लिए कुछ कीमत चुकानी पड़ती है।
Yes.
Giving back to the society.
Giving back to the society. What we mean as pay forward is, you do something to help others. You take such steps where others are going to benefit. You lead the way in a manner that five others can also lead with you. And that is the whole focus of. We've always heard of pay backward. You have all become successful, you are here in this institute because you have something to pay back to your institute which has made you. We are talking pay forward. See what others are going to do with your actions. And that is the culture that we would like to incorporate. This slide already, Dr. Mehta is doing things better and doing things at lower cost. These are what defines next generation. So what do we need for this? We need a global outlook for sure. We have been too much wearing horse clinkers and moving in our business because that's what happens to small entrepreneurs. You don't have time. You don't have time to really understand how your market is moving. Some people don't even know if they are asked who is your customer and they have a very narrow, limited outlook of who your customer for your product can be. So you need to have a global outlook on simple things as far as managing your business is concerned. You need an understanding ethos for entrepreneurship. You need a multidisciplinary exposure. If you ask an engineer to design a product, he will design a beautiful product, but he won't know what to do with that product. He needs a multidisciplinary exposure whereby he understands how marketing that product can be done, how costing that product can be done. He needs, you know, different talents. He needs a competitive and supportive culture around him and a good learning environment, and that is what the fundamentals for iCreate are. So a little bit about iCreate. It was launched by our Chief Minister, Shri Narendra Modi, on September 2011. The foundation stone ceremony was done in 2012. What is the vision of iCreate? To create, nurture, foster and promote ecosystems for breeding entrepreneurship that leverage various technologies and innovation. So it's not only an incubator, it is also much larger. The scope of activities and the vision is much larger to create a different kind of ecosystem in India, which is existing in other parts of the world, but still we need to really work on it in India. And what is the mantra? To be the most coveted place to be in the world if interested in the pursuit of technology and next generation. It should be the place where everybody aspires to go, because it's going to be a place where for entrepreneurship, whatever you need will be there. Whether it is mentors, whether it is advisors, whether it is facilitators, whether it is enablers, whether it is banks, whether it is money, access to markets, everything will be there. This is the advisory board. We have Mr. Shri Narayan Murthy as our chairman. We have Professor Jagdish Bhavati, Mr. Delgota, Mr. Maini. All stalwarts in the field of business, which is why we have access to very, very good sense of knowledge, as well as a huge pool of talent which can help us create new entrepreneurs. We have Mr. Jyoti Sagar, Dilip Sagar, each leader in his own field, from legal to energy.
And you can see the all these entrepreneurs mentioned here are first generation entrepreneurs. They are just like you. One day they were just like you. So there is nowhere that you cannot reach to the level that they have achieved in life. Except that you have to determine what.
The board and the founding team members were Dr. Mehta was the chief mentor. And we also have the dean of IIM Ahmedabad, we have the director of IIT Gandhinagar. They are all our working team members and also the founding members. Few people have also joined. Mr. K. Tyagarajan, who actively participates in the SME program. Mr. Gupta, who is a company secretary and is a big faculty at various incubators. So these are all people who have been in the field of incubation and helping people grow, strategize, everything since a very long time. What is the structure of iCreate? It is set up by Gujarat Foundation for Entrepreneurial Excellence. It's a joint venture with GMPC, so it's a government of Gujarat funded project. It's a Section 25 company, means it's a not-for-profit organization. It's an advisory board which is chaired by Shri Murthy. It has been allotted a 30-acre campus near Ahmedabad, and the intention is to make a world-class infrastructure in that campus, which will attract a lot of partner organizations from all over the world, as well as partners for entrepreneurship from all over the world. Until the campus is ready, we are already operating from the GMPC building. And, in fact, we will be happy to note that our first batch of incubation or incubators, what we call as grooming, for new businesses has already completed last year, out of which four projects are already incubated and they are already starting. What they mean by incubation is that from the beginning, from setting up, thinking of a good idea and making it into a business has already begun. So creating the next gen entrepreneurs, out of the first batch, 4 have already been incubated. And the new batch will start from 1st of February for the next batch. So what makes us unique? How are we different from other organizations and institutions of similar kind? We don't bet on projects, we bet on individuals. If we see a spark, a drive in an individual, we bet on that individual and we groom him in order to make a next generation of enterprise. The involvement is through the complete cycle, from college to high growth, IPO, and thereafter, also involvement of angel investment and VCs. All that is done within the institute itself. Company is born from the institute. End-to-end solutions are provided right from the ideation stage. So students, idea labs, grooming, picking up ideas, forming teams, everything is done within the institute. Last is, it's a unique strategic bilateral alliances with global institutions. I don't know how many of you have heard the word of the institution Technion. Technion is a leading institution from Israel, and they are known all over the world of churning the largest number of next generation entrepreneurs. They have made a mark in the world, and other such institutions. So these are our possible resources: advisory board, global affiliations, domain experts, experienced consultants and trainers, and angel investors and vendors that will follow at a later stage. So our job is to reach out to all different people: entrepreneurs, MSME, students, as well as principals and professors, because they are breeding the new generation entrepreneurs, the next generation entrepreneurs of tomorrow. So our job is also to apprise them and to help them create a supportive environment that we will have more and more entrepreneurs coming out of our institutions. So these are our target groups. We start from school, run programs in school in order for people and children to think out of the box. Our main activity is incubation and grooming. And the last one is MSME, where I come in. We conduct programs for MSME to scale up, what we call this. We facilitate select companies having high growth potentials. We have networking meetings. We have global technology awareness programs so that people are aware of the latest technologies moving in the world. And we also do that. So generally, as Dr. Mehta said, the tendency is that I need help, please help me. And for us, the main thing is we don't have all the gyan. We cannot have it. Nobody in the world can have all the gyan. You have the gyan for your business, which is why you started. Our job is only to ask the right questions. At some point of time in your organization, you stop asking the questions because you believe, as I said, that you are there. You believe that you have all the right answers. That is why you stop asking yourself the right questions about yourself as well as your organization. And that is our job. That is what we facilitate, that we want to ask the right questions. For example, what is driving you in your organization? That is something that most entrepreneurs at first level, if I ask, they are not able to answer. They have say, I have to think about it. Because they have forgotten what was the drive that got them into that enterprise. What will you do with your future? Do you want your business to just survive? Or do you want your business to grow? Do you have a vision over the next 3, 5, 7 years? Do you need to enlarge that vision? Do you need to decide what you want and prepare for success? Do you need to question yourself and move out of your comfort zone? Because there is a comfort zone that comes in after a while of what you are doing and what you are getting others to do. And it may be necessary to shift that comfort zone a little bit, get out of that comfort zone in order to take your company and organization and yourself forward. And these are the right questions that you need to ask. And this is what we nudge. We make sure that people start thinking about these things to enlarge their vision. So it's all about having the right mindset, having the right skill set, and having the right tool set to help you. What we started last year was to get people to have the right mindset. And what happens traditionally for every small entrepreneur, and it happened to me too, that you, after a while, become extremely lonely and out of touch with reality. You are out of touch with what is really working in this world. And you always believe that you are too small to be able to handle all that. I don't have the right resources, I don't have the right time, what will I do in a program like this? I have a meeting in Delhi, I have to run to Delhi. This is the traditional mindset of a small to medium entrepreneur who has too much on his plate. And you need to first create the right mindset, as Dr. Mehta put in his thing. How you are going to divest yourself of all the work? How you are going to sit and have tea with somebody? That is the first step of creating the right mindset to make your organization grow. Then you need the right tool sets. What am I going to use? How am I going to do it? What are the latest things? I don't know. And I don't have the time to look at it. Or I don't have anybody coming to me to mentor me or to tell me what to do. And I believe that I know everything, so I don't need the right tool set. And after you are exposed to the right tool sets, you also need the right skill sets. You need to also advance. Otherwise, how will you help your organization to advance? I don't know how many of you have done your MBAs, but even the MBA knowledge that you might have acquired when you started your business is outdated already. The marketing techniques are outdated. The technology techniques are outdated. We don't, as small manufacturers, don't even, I would say, see what is happening globally in the world today. How many of us attend every year an exhibition out of our own industry to know what new things are happening? And with that in mind, we designed the first program to enlarge your vision, to make sure that you are looking at different kinds of operations. You are doing different marketing skills, so everybody was exposed to the latest trends in each and every aspect of management in order to be able to ensure that you take the first step forward. We asked everybody to connect, everybody to become self-aware, we asked everybody to look at your own organizations, to start thinking differently. That was the first step. And it was interesting because when I was asked to come here to design a program for part two, the first question I asked is, so where are you now? Are you in a different place? And almost everybody said, we started thinking differently, but it is difficult to do. Which means the mindset was there that they want to change. They want to do something different, but it is difficult to adopt these practices. And this was, we felt, the right time to take into the advanced program. This was some feedback that we got. Whether the opportunity to network and learn from others was there, was it just too much, whether it was just right, or it was too little. And this is a collective of, we had a batch of 15 people, 15 organizations each day. Most of them felt that it was just right. The next satisfaction level was, as you can see, between 95% to 97%. Because our programs are tailor-made according to the group. They are not overall gyan which has come and taught to people. It is only to see that everybody benefits from the program. Everybody's expectations of the program are met. So that brings us to SME-EBV part. And I'm going to start with first that I see a lot of new faces here, and there is a possibility that there could be new people who want to join this program. And for them to acquire the right mindset and to become at level with the other group, We will have the first two sessions or three sessions as a recap program, so that even the old participants are brought back to the level that they were when we left. We are going to have a recap session of almost all the sessions over the first two or three Saturdays, depending on the group. And this time we said we must prove something different, since we are talking now of the next stage, and the next stage is acquiring the right rule set and also acquiring some skill sets. And we said we must walk through that program as a group. And I felt that Mr. Maribara's program is very inspiring. And if we have a cohesive group, then I do believe that each one of the group can actually contribute to the program. How they can collectively formulate a group and take themselves as well as the others forward. So with each session, we are going to start with a vision. What is it that you want to do with your company? And we are going to then start with your strategy. And it's going to be very, very specific. And since the feedback that I got was that you don't want to just learn, you want to actually do something. You want to do something with it, okay? If you want to do something, then we need to have more discussions. We should try and ensure that in every session, we talk about real problems. And we talk about real solutions. So every afternoon, we will have a group discussion program within the group, where we will pick up one company and their problem, and discuss possible solutions of those problems. And we will also try at the end of that day to get a facilitator, to get an expert from that field in order to be able to actually modulate the program. Because as I said, your problems are your own and the solutions also have to be worked out by you. For us, we are going to be facilitating to ensure that you come up with the most possibly right solution for yourself. So we designed the program such that we will be taking a lot of practical sessions, we will be doing a lot of practical exercises, and hopefully with every other session we will also have a technology tool which is available to you for that particular session. Whether it is HR, whether it is sales, whether it is marketing, whether it is finance. What are the latest technology tools that you can use and adopt in order to take your businesses? I think this detailing is on.